In this lesson, we're going to look at Gay-Lussac's law. So this law states that the pressure of a gas is directly proportional to the temperature measured in Kelvin if volume is kept constant and if we have a fixed mass, so we're not changing the amount of gas that we have. So once again, we'll look at a simulation of this. So we can see here that as there's an increase in temperature, the pressure is also increasing. So there's not a measurement of pressure here. There was before we could add mass to exert pressure, but here what we can see as we increase the temperature is that the particles are vibrating, moving around faster. So they have an increased kinetic energy. And as they're moving around faster, they are bumping into each other a lot quicker. There are a lot more collisions, and so that is increasing the pressure of those particles. So the formula that results from that is initial pressure divided by the initial temperature is equal to the final pressure divided by the final temperature. And once again, temperature must be measured in Kelvin here. So this is just another graph to show that relationship. So as we increase the temperature, the pressure is also increasing. So we have a direct relationship here. So that means if one of these increases, the other will increase. If one decreases, the other will also decrease. So if the pressure of a gas in a tank is 3.2 atmospheres at 22 degrees Celsius, and then there is an increase or a rise of 60 degrees Celsius, what will be the final pressure in the tank at that point? So to start with, our initial pressure is 3.2 atmospheres. Our initial temperature is 22 degrees Celsius plus 273 is 295 Kelvin. And we have our temperature rises to 60 degrees Celsius, which plus 273 gives us 333 Kelvin. So we have all those pieces of information. P1 over T1 equals P2 over T2. We'll pop in those values and we're looking to solve for final pressure. So this is a division by 333 Kelvin. So I'm gonna multiply by 333 Kelvin to isolate P2 to solve for that. And once again, canceling units, that will leave me with a final answer in atmospheres. So that will give me 3.61 atmospheres for my final pressure. Example two, so if I have a glass vessel that can only withstand a maximum internal pressure of 225 kilopascals, and that glass vessel gets filled with a gas at 21 degrees Celsius and is at 100 kilopascals, then it is heated. So at what temperature in degrees Celsius will the glass vessel burst? So our initial temperature, 21 degrees Celsius plus 273 is 294 Kelvin. Initial pressure is 100 kilopascals. And the pressure at which that would burst is going to be 225 kilopascals or just above that. And so we're going to look for what temperature that would happen at. So there are all our values and formula P1 over T1 equals P2 over T2. And we saw before when we are looking for a whatever is in the bottom, so in this case temperature, we can flip these around to make solving quicker and easier. So in this case, I would have 294 Kelvin over 100 kilopascals equals T2 over 225 kilopascals. So to isolate final temperature, this is a division by 225, so I would multiply by 225 kilopascals on that side, which is what that looks like. And when I solve for that, that is 661.5 Kelvin. If I subtract 273 from that, that is 388.5 degrees Celsius. So just above 388.5 degrees Celsius is where that glass vessel would shatter. So it said that it could withstand 225 kilopascals. So if we go over that, that's where it would shatter. And that would happen once we go over 388.5 degrees Celsius.